expression borrow time is anything but a meaningless phrase for the woman you're about to meet. They're the words she says have defined her life, never more so than now. Our cover story is reported by Tracy Smith.
This is the real one.
Yes, thank you for coming to me.
When Julie Yip Williams found out she was dying of cancer, she wasn't completely surprised.
I've always felt like I was living on borrowed time.
Why do you think that is?
Look at my life. It's a crazy life.
She's been thinking a lot about this crazy life lately, how it began and how it'll end. It started 42 years ago in post-war Vietnam. Julie was born totally blind. Immediately, her grandmother intervened.
She set up a meeting between my parents and this herbalist and had my mother and father take me to this man.
And your grandma's intention was what?
To have me killed.
Because
I was blind.
And she just thought there was absolutely no future in that?
There was no future for me. Nobody would ever want to marry me. I was an embarrassment to the family.
But instead, Julie says her life was spared.
So when they took you to this herbalist, what happened?
The herbalist said, I won't participate in this kind of dirty business. And he walked away. So the first photo is of me and my grandmother.
The grandmother.
The infamous grandmother.
She was three when her family fled Vietnam for the United States. They made it to California, where she says an eye surgeon changed her life.
You know, here's my mother, who doesn't speak any English, okay? And she gets me to this young pediatric ophthalmologist who's never seen a case like mine before. And he tells her, I don't know how much vision I can give her, but we can try.
What he gave her was enough.
But you're still legally blind.
I'm still legally blind. I cannot drive. I can't play tennis. Like, my dream is to play tennis.
Still, with an unstoppable will to succeed, she turned her newfound sight, considered a disability to most, into a competitive edge. And this formerly unwanted Vietnamese refugee earned her way into Harvard Law School and a career as a corporate lawyer.
How'd you end up at Harvard?
I think I was driven by a lot of anger.
Anger?
Anger. I had a lot of anger inside. And the anger came from my family not believing in me.
So you took that and said, I'll
screw
show them.
You.
Oh.
Yeah, screw you.
In fact, her life is now filled with everything her grandmother doubted she'd ever have. Julie did find love with her husband, Josh Williams, and they have two daughters. But at age 37, she was diagnosed with stage 4 colon cancer. It has an 11% five-year survival rate. And true to form, for the past 5 years, she's been fighting with just about every tool in the oncology arsenal.
So I've had multiple surgeries, multiple radiation treatments, multiple chemotherapy regimens, multiple clinical trials.
How are you doing?
I'm okay.
But when all those treatments failed...
So it sounds like it's been a hard 2 weeks, though, since then.
Right. The cancer spread.
We talked a little bit last time when I saw you about the scan that you had just had. And
right.
There were certainly some areas of stability, which was a good thing. But there were also some areas of growth.
It's not like I'm gonna bounce back.
No, there's no bouncing back anymore. No.
Make sure I don't see your cards.
Facing death. Julie says she knew she had to talk about it.
From the very moment that I had cancer, my kids knew. Sure, they were young, 1 and 3, but they had an understanding. Some understanding at that age.
Did you and Josh make a conscious decision
to
tell them?
I don't know if it was conscious. It was sort of intuitive because we're both such honest people with our children. And we didn't want to go around trying to avoid the C word.
Mia is now 8, Isabel 6.
What do you think of cancer?
Yeah. And have you talked to your mom about it?
Not really. Because it makes her sad.
Is that right, Mia? Why is that?
Because mommy's dying.
Do you worry that it's too much of a burden for these little girls to talk about these things?
I think that, you know, I've heard these so-called mental health professionals say, you know, that these kids are just, they're fragile, they're gonna break. And I think, well, you know, what I think of kids, they're like weeds, you know, bendable in the wind.
And they pop back up.
As long as we love them, they're gonna have the capacity to get through anything.
6-year-old Isabel agrees.
What would you say to people out there who say, oh, you're too young to talk about this stuff?
No, I'm not.
Why not?
Because it's actually happening in real life and you don't know how it feels like.
Julie hopes that through talking, her daughters won't fear her death. Sometimes, when you practice your instruments, I close my eyes so I can hear better. And she's written a letter to reassure the girls after their mother is gone. And when I do, I am often overcome with this absolute knowing that the music, with its special power, will beckon me, and I will be there.
What do you hope to impart?
I want them to find goodness out of their mother dying so young. I want them to learn how to live with passion and love. And I want them to also expect that no life is free of hardship. Embrace it and know that you will come out on the other side stronger.
4 years ago, she started a blog so her daughters would have her thoughts and words when they're older.
I have often dreamed that when I die, I will finally know what it would be like to see the world without visual impairment.
And in one last amazing twist, a major publisher has bought the rights to her blog. The memoir will be released after her death.
To see the minute details of a bird, to drive a car. Oh, how I long to have a perfect vision.
Truth is, Julie Yip Williams has a sort of vision the rest of us might envy. The ability to see challenges, and even death, as opportunity, to face them head on and with gratitude.
I've had this life, a somewhat difficult life, you know, where I've had to overcome a lot of things, right? But I want to convey within every human being is the capacity to overcome those same things. And we just have to find it.
Ahead.
I'm not gonna be a slave to a bloody machine for the rest of my life.
Luddites, explain.